Welcome, Maria Mahela Lucas. I wanted to ask you, what are the characteristics of a left that is increasingly pro-Islamist?
But the left is generally, traditionally against the state. So their analysis fails to take into account the proliferation of non-state actors, which have been there for several decades already. But they still stick to their old analysis, individuals versus the state.
And how does this affect the movement, progressive movement against the Islamists?
If I think of Algeria, for instance, we have been banging at the doors, not just of the left, but also the far left and also human rights organizations, to help us become more visible and give us legitimacy in our struggle against the fundamentalist far right, because that's what it is. It's a fascist type movement. Disguised as a religious movement, but it's a political movement, and we had absolutely no success. So the arguments they are using to justify their position of abandonment of the left in Muslim countries is of two types. One is a very human rights approach, which is, oh, it's their religion, it's their culture, and the second one is a more left approach. Well, they stand against oppressive and democratic government and corrupt governments, or they stand against imperialism. So neither of these arguments are valid. And if it's okay with you, I think I would like to develop this. On the first argument about it's their religion, it's their culture, one can say that they homogenize both religion and culture, and they essentialize both religion and culture. If one looks at the fact that Muslims are spread on all continents, it's really quite unbelievable to pretend that there's only one culture. And just looking at dress codes, you know, from saris to booze, from South Asia to Sub-Saharan Africa, there's a wide range of traditional clothing. And focusing on the Middle Eastern forms of clothing and of veiling, and pretending that this is religious instead of being adapted to geographical and circumstances, is absolutely crazy. I mean, how can anyone pretend there is one Muslim culture? As far as religion is concerned, of course, they are only concerned with the most retrograde and conservative interpretations of religion. They never look at what progressive thinkers in Islam say. And just for the sake of giving an example, Sohib Benchir, who is of Algerian descent and who was for a long time the great Mufti of Marseille in France, gives this very interesting analysis of the veil being Islamic. He says, what was the purpose of the veil at the time of the Prophet? It was a way to separate the slaves who were forced to go half naked with their breasts uncovered, and the decent wives of well-to-do people who had to be covered in order precisely not to be harassed by the man in the street. So Benchir says this was a way to make sure that the dignity of these women was not attacked. And then he goes on saying, it's not a piece of cloth today which performs the same, you know.
Purpose.
Yes. Today, what gives assurance to a woman to be respected in society is the fact that she's educated, she's better equipped to face society, and that's how she conquers her dignity in society. So he concludes that the modern equivalent of the veil is education. So these are interpreters of the Quran who are never ever quoted, neither by the left nor by human rights organizations. And it's interesting because in so doing, they actually support the most conservative and the most aggressive interpretations of Islam. As an atheist myself, I'm not concerned with involving myself in reform of Islam, but just for the sake of saying that they take sides, even if they don't declare it, by promoting the views of the fascists in Islam.
What about, I mean, this whole argument that my enemy's enemy is a friend? I mean, is that a permissible perspective to take? This is what the left often says.
That's doing. That's what the left says, yeah. Well, the first part of my response was more about human rights. But the human rights views are contaminating the left and have been doing so for quite some time. Certainly since the 90s in Algeria, I've been aware of that. That we receive from the left non-partisan responses, supposedly apolitical responses, which are immediately taken from the philosophy of human rights organizations. And this is not the role of the left.
What is the role of the left?
The role of the left should be to be partisan and to openly take side, and hopefully with us, not with the fascists.
In what way can...
Let me finish with this question of the enemy of my enemy, etc. That brings me back to the argument that because people, quote-unquote, people, the people, revolts against undemocratic, oppressive, corrupt governments, they need to be supported regardless of their political agenda. And supposedly because they oppose imperialist countries, which are well represented by our governments, let's say. So I think this is a terrible mistake for the left to believe for 1 second that fascist movements are anti-imperialist. The reform, the social reform that fundamentalist organizations are proposing the world over is zakat. That's, how do you say, give
alms
to the poor so that you don't disturb the social strata, the social power structure. So if this is going to fight against imperialism, let me laugh. What they fail to do, and I think this is absolutely unacceptable, is to have a political analysis of the right-wing, and in fact extreme right, nature of the fundamentalist movements. And I want to say that they have a lot in common with Nazis and fascists at the level of ideology. I know historians will jump to my throat because nothing can be compared to fascism in Europe at the time of the Second World War and before. But if we look at their ideology, they share with the Nazis and fascists the belief that they are a superior, not race, but creed. Nothing is superior to their creed. They base this fantasy, I would say, on the mythical past, whether it's the glorious past of Rome or the Aryan race, or in the case of Muslims, the golden age of Islam. And also based on that, they feel they have a right and a duty to eliminate the Untermensch. At the time of the Nazis, it was the Jews and the communists and the gays and the mentally handicapped, etc., etc. Gypsies, not to forget them. And now it's the coffers in a very general way, and also the Jews, the gays, etc. So I think this is extremely dangerous, and they have, as they say, God on their sides, just like the SS had the on their pocket, on their belt, yeah, God on my side, yeah. So I think failing to see the similarities and thinking we can ally as a left worldwide with these people, this is dramatic in my views. And I think the left in Europe and North America, but also in Asia and Africa, is participating in the elimination of any progressive thinking, any progressive movements all over the so-called Muslim world.
Thank you.